Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Advent, we have pointed the way to Christmas by lighting candles that represent the spirit of the child born to us this night. They were the candles of peace, joy, love, and hope. Our Advent journey is now complete.
The darkness is gone. The light of the world is here. And so, tonight, we light the candle of Christ, celebrating the birth of our Savior.
With the coming of this light, let there be peace.
With the coming of this light, let there be joy.
With the coming of this light, let there be love.
With the coming of this light, let there be hope, that goodness will prevail in our lives and world, that oppression will end, that what unites us is stronger than what divides us, and that we will find our way in the light of God. All the candles are now lit as we proclaim the coming of God into the world. Let us worship the light together.
Once in a royal city stood I. will see a great light, a light that will shine on all who live in the land where death cast its shadow. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders. These will be his royal titles: Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Surprising generosity and unexpected grace, we have come to witness a miracle, to prepare our hearts for a new invasion of your light. We have come this night to open our souls and our lives to the divine birth, and in this sacred moment, we ask for your gentle presence to captivate and challenge us. This we pray. Amen.
You may be seated. The tree is all set, packages piled at its base, telephone calls from the kids confirming the times of dinner and church. Nothing much left to do. The FedEx guy just delivered the last late order. I'll wrap it, and then what? Time on my hands, time to think. What is it all about? Christmas is about family, gathering together to celebrate, We do this in-gathering every year of our lives and come to associate this night and the days around it with the people closest to our hearts. But always, there is someone who is no longer here, who is still in our hearts but forever gone from our embrace. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. What the songwriter doesn't say is, the fates will not allow it. Because we are mortal beings, and just as we all begin our journeys as babies, adored by mothers and admirers, we will all eventually be aches in the hearts of those who miss us. It's Christmas Eve when the ache is the worst. And that is why we turn again to the baby, to celebrate birth that soothes the aching heart, that gives us reason to hope and dream, that reminds us of the miracle of life and tells us by this annual gathering of family that it is our very mortality that makes life that begins as a baby, so precious. Not in spite of, but because of our heartache, this is a silent and holy night in which, through adoration of a baby, we celebrate life.
Angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and her name was Mary. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary,
for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb
and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word."
For the world is about to turn. That is, the world is about to change. That is, the world is about to be better. That is, the world is full of hope. That is, the world is not as hateful as it seems. For the world is about to turn our weapons into plowshares, our fears into compassion, our hatred into love. For the world is about to turn. Mary, Jesus' mother, sings with ferocity as she stands in a line in the humidity of Orlando to donate blood. Mary, Jesus' mother, sings with tears streaming down her face as she learns of her son's senseless death. Mary, Jesus' mother, sings for her life and for the lives of others, poor, marginalized, ridiculed, hated. For the world is about to turn. Mary's voice is not sweet. It does not hit every note with perfect pitch. It is gritty. It is filled with zeal. It is the voice of conviction. It is the voice crying out for the fires of God's justice to burn, to refine, to change, to tear down systems of injustice so we can begin building up systems of love. For the world is about to turn. When I sing Mary's song, I am forced to pay attention. The God to whom Mary sings is not a passive God, but an active one, a forceful one, a God who runs through the streets shouting justice, mercy, love. Mary's God wipes away tears, sets tables for the hungry, uproots tyrants from their thrones, burns injustice to the ground, frees captive from enslavement. Mary's God makes a playlist for a dance party, inviting all God's children, every last single one of them, to dance, to play, to party. For the world is about to turn. We can only hope to turn along with it, to join Mary's God at the party, to show up in the blood drive lines, to help set the feasting table for all. The world is turning, my friends. That is, it is changing, hoping, loving all at once. May we join the movement of love, singing with the ferocity of Mary, moving with the force of God.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to their own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. And while they were there, the time came for Mary to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and placed him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
Thank you.
Suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among people with whom God is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
And apprehension, Christmas enters, streaming lights of joy, ringing bells of hope, and singing carols of forgiveness high up in the bright air. The world is encouraged to come away from rancor, come the way of friendship. Hope is born again in the faces of children. It rides on the shoulders of our aged as they walk into their sunsets. Hope spreads around the earth, brightening all things, even hate, which crouches breeding in dark corridors. In our joy, we think we hear a whisper. At first, it is too soft, then only half heard. We listen carefully as it gathers strength. We hear a sweetness. The word is peace. It is loud now. It is louder, louder than the explosions of bombs. We tremble at the sound. We are thrilled by its presence. It is what we have hungered for. Not just the absence of war, but true peace. A harmony of spirit, a comfort of courtesies. Security for our beloveds and their beloveds. We clap hands and welcome the peace of Christmas. We beckon this good season to wait a while with us. We, Baptists and Buddhists, Congregationalists and Muslim, say, come. Peace, come and fill us and our world with your majesty. We, the Jew and the Jainist, the Catholic and the Confucian, implore you to stay a while with us so we may learn by your shimmering light how to look beyond complexion and see community. It is Christmas time, the halting of hate time.
this most beautiful and glorious evening, I welcome each and every one of you to Coral Gables Congregational Church. We are part of a denomination called the United Church of Christ that has a saying which I believe can tell you everything you need to know about us. The saying is this: no matter who you are or where you are on your life journey, you are welcome here. And the very best part is, we mean it. And so we extend a warm welcome to each of you. Whether you're having problems or you're down in the dumps or you don't like organized religion, we've been there too. We offer a very special welcome to those of you who could use a prayer right now, or perhaps have had religion shoved down your throat, or who took a wrong turn at the traffic circle on Granada on their way to Little Flower Catholic Church and wound up here by mistake. Welcome, tourists, seekers, doubters, the faithful and the faithless. In other words, we welcome each of you. And if somehow there is something in you, some small voice seeking a place to live out your faith, to ask important questions, to serve beyond yourself, we invite you into our community, not just on special holidays such as this, but in the ordinary, everyday challenges and joys of life. We do also want to extend a very special welcome to some choir members from the Miami Temple Seventh-day Adventist Congregation who join us in our celebration this night. Earlier today, members of our choir joined them in their Christmas Eve service. In a day and a time when there seems to be separation and division between faith communities and traditions, I am so proud to be a part of a congregation that has an ecumenical and interfaith heart, as well as a heart for sharing the gospel of justice and peace with our community and the wider world. This evening, we are hearing powerful stories of ordinary people such as Mary, Joseph, and shepherds who believed beyond measure and provided space for the peace and love of God to enter into the world. Faith does require tenderness and courage, a kind of big love that is committed to changing people's lives in our community and in the world around us, even in our own. So your offering evening will help transform the lives of those who are hungry, homeless, hopeless, living lives of no justice or peace. And so may we, like ordinary folk who we remember this night, respond to the amazing things God is doing as we gather up our gifts. Will the ushers please come forward as we receive our Christmas offering?
we say our dedication. Loving God, may these offerings bring hope, peace, love, and joy to others who seek a better life for themselves. Use our gifts to do justice in a world of neglect and indifference. May the coming of the Christ Child inspire all of us to give generously of our time, talent, and treasure. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, in the midst of our wondering doubt and faithful hope, we gather in this night of mystery and birth, our hearts filled with inexpressible gratitude. We have gathered here to bear witness to love so amazing, so divine, that nothing in our lives is able to remain the same. For this is the night that all things are to be made new. And so we would pray that you bring your healing presence to each of us, touching those places in our lives of insecurity, doubt, guilt, regret, hurt. Settle us into your comforting love, so that we may reflect your care not only in our lives, but for those around us in the coming days. We would pray this night for the world around us, for those for whom Merry Christmas is a dim memory or a deep sadness. We pray for those who are broken, lonely, addicted, sick, not well, either physically or emotionally. Those who are frightened, those who are living in the midst of war. Be harmony in families, tranquility to the troubled. Be life to the dying. Be liberation to the oppressed. Be the conscience of all leaders. Be truth in all policymakers. Be the gospel to all seekers, and be the peace on earth that we so long for this night. We know not what the future brings, O God, but through our gathering around you here, we welcome all wonders in one sight and dream with you the wonders yet to be. May it be so. Amen.
I've heard about this baby boy who came to earth to bring us joy, and I just wanna sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, with every breath I'm singing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only Son was born. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see the baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angels said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel, the Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Be instruments of hope in the world. We so choose, so we go to spread the hope and promise of a coming child. If you choose, you can counter the voices of anxiety and despair in the world. We so choose. Sing of hope, because the world can be changed. If you choose, you can fight against the fear that freezes the hearts of many.
We so choose.
So we will tell of the love that conquers fear, the love of a child in a manger. The choice is ours to make, how we live into the possibilities of Christmas.
And the beauty is
choices. Be with God, who feeds our hopes and quiets our fears, always.
En el principio ya existía la palabra. La palabra estaba con Dios y Dios mismo era la palabra. La palabra estaba en el principio con Dios. Por ella fueron hechas todas las cosas. Sin ella no fue hecho de lo que ha sido hecho. Ella estaba la vida y la vida era la luz de la humanidad. La luz resplandece en las tinieblas y las tinieblas no prevalecieron contra ella.
on this night, this Navidad, when we contemplate
the very nature of God's presence, let us go from here, determined to be familiar for one another, determined to welcome God into our hearts and into our imagination on this night of reflection on the nature of God's power. Let us go from here, turned outward to the needs of this broken, beautiful world. And may the blessings of Christmas make us a blessing to others. Go now in the light of Christ.